So now prepare the bank account. Write the column. Sorry, write the column headings. The particulars rupees, and write the debit and credit corner of the account. So let's start here. ಯಾವಾಗ ನೀವು ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿರಲ್ಲ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ತಗೋಬೇಕು ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಬೈ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ದ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಬೈ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಬ್ರಾಡ್ ಡನ್ ಈ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಶೀಟ್ ದಾಗ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರ್ತಾರೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಶೀಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ 10,000 ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಅಟ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಪೋಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ನರ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ನರ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ತಗೊಂಡು ಬಂದಿರೋ ಒಂದು ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಎಂಟ್ರಿ ಐತಿ ಮತ್ತೊಂದು ವಿತ್ಡ್ರಾನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಗುಡ್ ವಿಲ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಸೊ ದೋಸ್ ಪೋಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಟೇಕನ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಸೊ ಆನ್ ದ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಸೈಡ್ ದ ಡೆಬಿಟ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಬರ್ತೈತಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆರ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಆರ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ 40,000 ಅಂಡ್ ಡೆಬಿಟ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಪೋಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಇದು ಗುಡ್ ವಿಲ್ ವಿತ್ಡ್ರಾನ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದು ಟು ಪೀಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಸಾರಿ ಬೈ by P's capital account and by Q's capital account 4,500 and 4,500 so now make it total and one more entry is there you left that goodwill goodwill bring madidanna entry barbeku cash or bank on debit to goodwill account athi journal entry so bank account daga debit side goodwill anta barbeku ಗುಡ್ವಿಲ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ತಗೊಂಡು ಬಂದಾರೆ ಅವ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ 9,000 ಸೊ ನೌ ಮೇಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಸೊ 10,000 40,000 59,000 ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ 59,000 ಅಂಡ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ರಿಮೈನ್ಸ್ 50,000 ದಿಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಟೇಕನ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಅಸೆಟ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಶೀಟ್ Here only necessary accounts are revaluation account, partners capital account, bank account and new balance sheet. So, goodwill account is not prepared yet. So let's start the new balance sheet. First take the balance sheet items, old balance sheet items which are left in the, that is creditors. Creditors amount 40,000. 40,000 creditors amount and bank loan is there. Bank loan 25,000 and now take capital items capitals P Q R for P 75,150 55,150 and 40,000 for R these are the capital balances from the partners capital account now you take any other unrecorded liabilities those should be taken here so first one that is outstanding expense is there so that is outstanding expense that is in the adjustment notes that's why you should entry of two side this 300 and now on the asset side first one cash at bank cash at bank how much cash at bank should be taken here 50,000 50,000 cash at bank. Next, stock. Stock how much? 30,000 directly. There is no adjustment for the stock value. Next one, debtors. Debtors for debtors adjustment is there. So debtors value in the balance sheet is 20,000 and there is a adjustment. So PDD at 5%. So that becomes 1,000. It is 90,000. Next one, motor car. For motor car, depreciation is there. Less depreciation at 20%. 20% is there. So, motor car value in the balance sheet is 20,000. 20% 4,000 it is so motor car value 20,000 and depreciation 4,000 it becomes 16,000 outer column next one plant and machinery plant and machinery value in the balance sheet 30,000 and depreciation is there. Less depreciation at 5%. So on the 30,000, you calculate 5%. It is 1,500. That becomes 28,500 outer column. Next one, buildings. Buildings value in the balance sheet 60,000 is there. And there is an appreciation in the building that should be added. Appreciation at 10%. Appreciation at 10%. So on 60,000, you calculate 10%. That is 6,000. 66,000 outer column. Next one, investments. Investments. There is also appreciation in the investment value. That should be added here. Appreciation at 7.5%. 7.5. So value of investment is 10,000. So on the 10,000 value, you calculate 7.5%. It is 750. So 10,750 is the closing investment value. Next one. And now, bills receivable. Bills receivable amount is 16,000. And there is adjustment. That is decreased. Or provision. Provisions at bills receivable is 5%. At 5%. So on 16,000, you calculate 5 divided by 100, 5%. So that becomes 800. So 15,200 is the closing bills receivable value. And now balance sheet items are over here. Any other left adjustment values should be taken. Commission receivable is there. Commission receivable. So income receivable, it is an asset, unrecorded asset it is. So amount of the income receivable is 150. So now make it tally. Tally amount here 2,35,600. Here also 2,35,600. Make sure that this is answer is correct. By using the calculator you confirm it. This tally amount is correct or not. So thank you.